The sanctified life, substituting feeling for reason. Many who profess sanctification are entirely ignorant of the work of grace upon the heart. When proved and tested, they are found to be like the self-righteous Pharisee. They will bear no contradiction. They lay aside reason and judgment and depend wholly upon their feelings, basing their claims to sanctification upon emotions which they have at some times experienced. They are stubborn and perverse in urging their tenacious claim of holiness, giving many words but bearing no precious fruit as proof. These professedly sanctified persons are not only deluding their own souls by their pretensions, but are exerting an influence to lead astray many who earnestly desire to conform to the will of God. They may be heard to reiterate again and again, "God leads me, God teaches me, I am living without sin." Many who come in contact with the Spirit encounter a dark, mysterious something which they cannot comprehend. But it is that which is altogether, unlike Christ, the only true pattern. Bible sanctification does not consist in strong emotion. Here is where many are led into error. They make feelings their criterion. When they feel elated or happy, they claim that they are sanctified. Happy feelings or the absence of joy is no evidence that a person is or is not sanctified. There is no such thing as instantaneous sanctification. True sanctification is a daily work continuing as long as life shall last. Those who are battling with daily temptations, overcoming their own sinful tendencies, and seeking for holiness of heart and life make no boastful claims of holiness. They are hungering and thirsting for righteousness. Sin appears to them exceedingly sinful. There are those claiming sanctification who make a profession of the truth like their brethren, and it may be difficult to make a distinction between them, but the difference exists nevertheless. The testimony of those claiming such an exalted experience will cause the sweet Spirit of Christ to withdraw from a meeting and will leave a chilling influence upon those present, while if they were truly living without sin, their very presence would bring holy angels into the assembly, and their words would indeed be like apples of gold in pictures of silver. Proverbs 25, verse 11. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 1, True and False Theories Contrasted.